Welcome to our next video where we discuss about the double integral. In my previous video, you see beta functions, gamma function. Now we discuss about double integral, triple integral, change of order of integration, area, volume, surface. Find out with the help of these double integrals. So, what do you mean by double integral? Integral means this line, double means we have integrate any function with respect to two variables. Means there are two variables are given, x and y or maybe anything. So this double integral is, we can learn definite double integrals, means we have to limit also a to b and something 1 to 2 fx y dx dy. Means this is a double integral. One time we have to integrate with respect to x, keeping y constant. The next time we have to integrate with respect to y. Then we have to get final solution. And how we decide which limits are going or represent to x or which limits are represent to y. If both limits are in constant form, then this 1 to 2 is outside and inside, both are constant, then this limit is for x, outside limit is for y. But if sometimes 0 to 1, 0 to x square, f x y dx dy. See, in this case, then we saw this limit in terms of x, okay? So this is the limit of y, means y is equal to 0 and y is equal to x square. Always this limit, whatever the parameter is given, that is the limit for other parameter. That's why when we solve this first for y, apply the limit, then entire function convert into x, and then we have to integrate it with respect to x. And then apply the limit of x, we will get the solution. So what we can do, this is limit of x, so our we can solve it like that. Y going from 0 to x square fxy dy. First we have to solve this keeping x as constant for this case. Applying the limit, all given function convert into x form, then we have to integrate with respect to x, we will get the required solution. So that's it for double integral. Now I will solve you one double integral for you, so you can easily understand how we can evaluate double integral. If we have 0 to 1, 0 to 1 plus x square dx dy upon 1 plus x square plus y square. Now we have to solve it, so we decide which one is the limit for x, which one is the c. Inner limit is in terms of x, it means it is the limit for y. So if this is the limit for x, x is going from 0 to 1 and y is going from 0 to 1 minus 1 plus x square. So first we have to integrate this with respect to y, keeping x as a constant. At the end we have to integrate with respect to x. So we rewrite 0 to 1 dx come outside, 0 to 1 plus x square dy upon 1 plus x square plus y square. So this is we have to using integral formula. Integration of dx upon a square plus x square is what? 1 by a tan inverse of xy. Clear? This is dx. You all know that this is 1 by a tan inverse of xy. So if we put under root of this square. So this is your a, this is your x. So what is coming next? Here. 1 by a under root of 1 plus x square tan inverse x by a 1 plus x square. Apply the limit taking constant outside 0 to under root of 1 plus x square. That's all. So when we apply the limit up, always you remember when you apply the limit, upper limit minus lower limit. So when we apply upper limit, tan inverse this at the place of y, we put 1 root of 1 plus x square, it will becomes 1. So this gives and tan inverse of 0. So tan inverse of 1 minus tan inverse of 0. Very good. So what comes next? 0 to 1 dx upon under root of 1 plus x square tan inverse 1 minus tan inverse 0. Tan inverse 1 equal to tan inverse 1 pi by 4. Tan inverse 0 0. Very good. So this gives pi by 4, which is constant we are taking outside. So pi by 4 0 to 1 dx upon under root of 1 plus x square. What is this? Dx upon under root of 1 plus x square. 1 4 log of x log of x plus under root of 1 plus x square limit 0 to 1. Dx upon a under root of a square plus x square is what? 1 by a is 1. Log of x plus under root of a square plus x square. Now apply the limit. So it gives pi by 4 log of 1 plus 1. So gives log 2 minus of log. This gives when you apply 1 plus 1 plus 1, 2. So log of 1 plus root of 2 minus log of 0. Yeah, so this is 0. So your answer is pi by 4 log of 1 plus root 2. It means what is main task? First we have to decide the limits which are for x or y. After that we have to integrate it, limit, apply the limit, and second time again integrate it and then apply the limits. Just simple process for double integration. Some more example I can show you. Very easy in double integration, sometimes we can solve this when we find the integration in terms of beta gamma function. So directly we apply beta, this is form of beta, beta mn, or this is form of gamma, so gamma of that. I will show you one example which is going for gamma function. Question is, if 0 to infinity, 0 to infinity e to the power minus x cube upon root x y to the power 4 e to the power minus y to the power 6 dx dy. Hence there are two functions, both limit are same, so we separate 0 to infinity e to the power minus x cube upon root x dx. Second will be 0 to infinity y to the power 4 e to the power minus y to the power 6 dy. We separate the term, all dy collect with y and all y collect with dy and all x collect with dx. Now what we can do, we put here y to the power 6 equal to t, and here x to the power 1 by 2 equal h, sorry, e to the power, x to the power 3 equal to, if put x to the power 3 equal to p, then x is equal to p to the power 1 by 3, and dx is equal to 1 by 3 p to the power minus 2 by 3 dp. Similarly here, if we put, sorry, y, not our parameter, is y, y to the power 6 is equal to q, then y is equal to q to the power 1 by 6, dy is equal to 1 by 6, q to the power minus of 5 by 6, dq. Clear? So, now we substitute this here. Our next is the limit also. When you convert the parameter, you can apply the limit. When x is equal to 0, p is equal to 0. When x is equal to infinity, p is equal to infinity also. Similarly, here also, q 0, y 0. When y is infinity, q is infinity. So, 0 to infinity, e to the power minus of p, x. Sorry, x is p to the power 1 by 3. P to the power 1 by 3, and this is minus of 1 by 2 into 1 by 3, and dx is equal to 1 by 3 p to the power minus 2 by 3 dp. Clear? This is one integral. Similarly, we have to substitute here also. So this terms give 0 to infinity by 4. Y means q to the power 4 by 6 e to the power minus of q, dy is 1 by 6 q to the power minus 5 by 6 dq. So now our integrals converted into q and p. Again rearrange the terms, taking all constant. There is 1 by 3, there is 1 by 6, so 1 by 18 totally taking outside. 0 to infinity e to the power minus p, p to the power minus 1 by 6 plus, means minus 1 by 6 minus 2 by 3. So minus 1 by 6 and plus 2 by 3 is, we can write 5 by 6. So p to the power 1 by 6 minus of 1, this gives 5 by 6. dp cross 0 to infinity e to the power minus q, q to the power 4 by 6 minus of 5 by 6 gives 4 by 6 gives minus of 1 by 6. So minus of 1 by 6 is 5 by 6 minus 1 is minus of. You think how, why we write this terms like this? 5 by 6 we write 1 by 6 minus 1. 1 by 6 we write 5 by 6 minus 1. Yes, because it is, we can compare these integrals with gamma integral. You see, what is gamma function? Gamma, if we write gamma n is equal to 0 to infinity, e to the power minus p, p to the power n minus 1 dt. Now compare 0 to infinity e to the power t, t to the power n minus 1, means this is gamma of 1 by 6, this is gamma of 5 by 6. So this gives 1 by 8, gamma of 1 by 6 and gamma of 5 by 6. Again 1 by 6 we rewrite, 1 by 18, 5 by 6 minus, sorry, 1 minus 5 by 6. 1 minus 5 by 6 and gamma of 5 by 6.